Greetings all, welcome to my video. From CollectiveEvolution.com. The builder of Gnosis Apollo Communications Systems blows the whistle on extraterrestrials. By Arjun Walia. The facts. Maurice Chatelain designed and built Gnosis Apollo Communications Systems. He wrote a book detailing his experience with the Apollo programs, and said that all of the missions experienced UFO activity, and other strange anomalies. Reflect on. It seems that there is an overwhelming amount of witness testimony from insiders. How has this gone ignored for so long, and how come all of these people never get any attention, or airtime like the ones who don't speak about it? His name is Maurice Chatelain. If you look him up on Google, you may not find much. IMDb states that he is usually identified as a former NASA chief of communications, especially by ufologists. Other sources claim he was merely a low-level engineer who worked for a NASA subcontractor. Obviously, whoever wrote this has poor research skills. One needs to look no further than his book, Our Ancestors Came from Outer Space, to find a description of his life and what he's experienced. From here, a researcher would go about looking for confirmations outside of his own claims. Chatelain's details about his career and his designs that he mentions in his book can be found online. We'll get to that in a bit. Chatelain was a telecommunication, telemetry, and communication electronics specialist, and during his time, perhaps the best in the world at what he did. After he moved to America from Europe decades ago, he spent the next 20 years of his life working for a number of aerospace organizations and industries, and was also supported by the United States Navy, the United States Air Force, and NASA. He was even reimbursed by the United States government for the cost of moving his family to the United States. In his book, he details his various patents and designs for the companies that he worked for and the organizations his designs attracted. As you can see, these are just a few of his many contributions to the field. In his book, he goes on to explain in great detail how through his work and his connections, he was immediately offered the task of designing and building the Apollo Communication and Data Processing System. He also explains how nobody specified his duties or functions, because no one at that time knew what these systems would be like. There were very few experts in the field. Chatelain was in charge of all of what he mentions below. When the Apollo project started, there was no communication equipment powerful enough or sensitive enough to make voice transmission possible from Earth to Moon, not to mention transmission of television pictures over that distance. Such things had to be invented, perfected, and built. Relay stations had to be installed all around the globe, in the tropics, with parabolic dish antennas, some over 200 feet in diameter, in such a way that one or two of them would always be in contact with any Apollo spacecraft orbiting around the Moon. All these stations had to be in contact with each other, and all of them had to report to the Apollo Space Flight Center in Houston, Texas. All the new equipment, built by some 20 different suppliers from all parts of the United States, had to be CO-ordinated and made compatible. It's interesting to think about these things. When contemplating the Apollo missions, it's not often we think about the tremendous amount of work that went into it by so many men and women. Many of them, like Chatelain, go practically unknown, as the focus is always on the astronauts, who themselves have also been quite outspoken and have corroborated Chatelain's disclosures. The famous Leonard Nimoy featured Chatelain in one of his documentaries regarding ancient aliens, decades ago. He also verified his background, which has been done by many, by introducing him as a NASA space scientist who helped man reach the Moon. The film features other prominent minds and academics at the time. Chatelain is also referenced by many prominent UFO researchers. He was also featured on what appears to be a French talk show, found on YouTube. So what did Chatelain have to say in his book regarding the Apollo missions? During these missions, several strange things happened. Some still cannot be talked about, and some I will mention, without revealing my sources of information, and with the utmost reserve, because I personally was not there, when these incidents allegedly took place. It could be, for example, that both the American and the Russian space programs did bring back discoveries that were not anticipated. He goes on to state that most of the astronauts saw strange things during their mission that could not be discussed with anybody outside of NASA. Obviously, since the time of Chatelaine, there are so many astronauts that have spoken up about what they saw and what they know. It seems that a large percentage of the Apollo astronauts have all made such comments. Apollo 14 Dr. Edgar Mitchell expressed that he had knowledge of extraterrestrial visitation and that there have been crashed craft and bodies recovered. Gordon Cooper, part of the very first manned mission to space, said the same thing. Dr. Brian O'Leary is another, who admitted to there being abundant evidence existing for the fact that we are being contacted. Story Musgrave, another Apollo 12 astronaut Al Worden, shared his thoughts on the matter not long ago. He stated his belief that our ancestors came from outer space. It's funny because that's the title of Chatelaine's book. The list doesn't end there, but I'll stop. It's not just astronauts, it's scientists from within these organizations as well, like Dr. John Brandenburg, the deputy manager for the Clementine mission to the moon, and Norman Berggruen, a veteran Ames research scientist and a key member of the Voyager missions. I recently wrote an article about Berggruen and what he has exposed. It shows a picture of a giant UFO hovering just outside Saturn's outer ring. Chatelaine goes on to write, "It is very difficult to obtain any specific information from NASA, which still exercises a very strict control over any disclosure of these events. It seems that all Apollo and Gemini flights were followed, both at a distance and sometimes also quite closely, by space vehicles of extraterrestrial origin, flying saucers, or UFOs, if you want to call them by that name. Every time it occurred, the astronauts informed mission control, who then ordered absolute silence." He provides specific examples that he's aware of. The following year, on November 12, 1966, James Lovell and Edwin Aldrin, in Gemini 12, also saw two UFOs at slightly over half a mile from the capsule. These were observed for quite some time, and photographed repeatedly. The same happened to Frank Borman and James Lovell, in Apollo 8, on Christmas Eve 1968, and to Thomas Stafford and John Young, aboard Apollo 10 on May 22, 1969. The UFOs showed up both during the orbit around the Moon, and on the homeward flight of Apollo 10. Below is a picture from ex-Command Sergeant Major Bob Dean, who was good friends with Berggruen. He supposedly obtained some pictures that NASA had locked away. It comes from this lecture. Corroboration. Having been an avid researcher in the field for quite some time, and I am sure many others will tell you this, it's not uncommon at all to come across similarities and stories that intersect among multiple, credible sources. For example, in his book, Chatelaine also mentions nuclear weapons testing on the Moon. There was even some talk that the Apollo 13 mission carried a nuclear device aboard that could be set off to make measurements of the infrastructure of the Moon, and whose detonations would show on the charts of several recording seismographs L8, placed in different locations. The unexplained explosion of an oxygen tank in the service module of Apollo 13 on its flight to the Moon, according to rumors, was caused deliberately by a UFO that was following the capsule to prevent the detonation of the atomic charge that could possibly have destroyed or endangered some Moon bases established by extraterrestrials. Well, there was a lot of talk and there still is. This is interesting, because decades after Chatelaine wrote his book, Colonel Lauren Ross Dedrickson, assigned to the U.S. Atomic Energy Commission, and a man who had a long service with the Energy Commission between 1950 to 1958, which included contract administration duties at Nevada test sites, Pacific Nuclear Test Area west of Hawaii, nuclear weapon manufacturing, and quality assurance in Albuquerque, and inspection of nuclear and non-nuclear facilities throughout the country. He stated the same thing, that we tried to send a nuclear weapon to the Moon, and he also references Apollo 13. A spacecraft went to the rescue of Apollo 13, and they accompanied Apollo 13 on their voyage around the moon, back to Earth. And on two occasions, they thought they might have to transfer the crew to their spacecraft, but they saw them safely back to Earth. He also stated, "I also learned about incidents involving nuclear weapons, and among these incidents were a couple of nuclear weapons sent into space, were destroyed by the extraterrestrials, at the very end of the 70s, and the early 80s, we attempted to put a nuclear weapon on the moon, and explode it for scientific measurements, and other things, which was not acceptable to the extraterrestrials. They destroyed the weapon before it got to the moon." Is there any documentation to support these claims? Yes, a declassified report by the Air Force Nuclear Weapons Center, from June 1959, shows just how seriously they considered the plan, called Project A-119. In general, they wanted to investigate the capability of weapons in space, as well as gain further insight into the space environment, and the detonation of nuclear devices within it. It seems that they did, and obviously the public would not know that the US is taking a nuclear weapon to space, it would be classified. UFOs and nuclear weapons go hand in hand, that's another topic in itself. Chatelain also describes extraterrestrial encounters of the moon, and code words used to describe extraterrestrial spacecraft, like Santa Claus. He is not the only insider to do so either. The takeaway here is to really recognize just how much witness testimony we've had come out over the decades from credible sources. Furthermore, it's 2019, we now have physical evidence, electro-optical data, and radar trackings to go along with it. We know we are not alone, and it's stories like these that have been wrongfully kept from humanity. Transparency, exploration, and discovery, and truth, is not something which should be denied to the human race. It's our birthright. It's hard to tell what's going on sometimes, but at the end of the day, it's quite clear that something is. This is a topic where one must remain skeptical, especially of mainstream media, and the way they do and will cover it. The truth is out there. Thank you for watching. Please help spread the word, and make a difference, by sharing and subscribing for more thought-provoking content, and give us a thumbs up if you liked the video. Your support is greatly appreciated. Be aware, and stay safe.